Welcome back. This is Marc Rudov, branding advisor to CEOs and author of 3 books on branding for CEOs. You can get my books at markrudov.com/books. Watch all of my videos at markrudov.tv. And don't forget to tune in to wokeceonews.com. Well, you don't really tune in. Just look at all the blunders and idiotic moves that CEOs are making under the guise of wokeness, such as the ones running Anheuser-Busch. As Trump would say, these are not smart people. Today's topic, wasting corporate cash through Super Bowl commercials, Super Bowl advertising. Did this last year, the year before that. Wrote a lot about it in Brand is Destiny. Super Bowl commercials, why are they wastes of money? Because advertising has one job, sell the product. It's not supposed to be entertainment, but Super Bowl commercials are nothing but entertainment. People vote on their favorite Super Bowl commercials. That means they're not doing their jobs. What are their jobs? Sell products. They've done study after study after study. People don't buy the products purveyed on Super Bowl commercials. Therefore, they are unbelievable wastes of money. And this year, they're going for about $7 million per 30-second spot. That's a lot of corporate cash down the drain. This year, after a huge blunder with Dylan Mulvaney, Budweiser is bringing back the Clydesdales to try to get you to buy beer. I think if you watch this commercial that's going to be shown on Sunday, you're going to ask yourself, what does this have to do with buying beer or getting me excited? The answer is nothing. The Clydesdales didn't work in the past, and they're not going to work this year, especially with this ridiculous 60-second spot, which is going to cost Budweiser about $20 million. $20 million for what? Roll it.
Come on.
All major highways are currently closed.
You've got to be kidding me.
What do you want to do?
Hey. All right. Let's do it the old school way. Let's go.
We're running low, Bud.
Can't see anything. Look. Good job, Bubba. Sorry I'm late.
Okay, as I said, branding is about connection, not awareness. Did you feel connected to anything watching that spot? I didn't. It's a real head scratcher. Again, when it comes to spending other people's money, CEOs don't seem to care. Now, let me play a clip from last year when I talked about the most iconic commercial of all. From 1979, Coca-Cola with Mean Joe Green. Roll it. A lot of you might remember an iconic commercial featuring Mean Joe Green of the Pittsburgh Steelers and Coca-Cola from 1979. People talked about it for days and weeks and months and years. They still talk about it. I want you to watch it now.
Please, please, take him out.
Mr. Green? Mr. Green?
Yeah.
You need any help?
Mm-mm.
I just want you to know, I think you're the best ever.
Yeah, sure.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
No.
Really, you can have it.
Okay. Thanks.
Makes me feel good. Makes me feel nice.
Be around.
That's the way it should be. I like to see.
Hey, kid.
The whole world is smiling with me. Don't the color has life. Have a good day.
Thanks, Mean Joe.
Smile.
Pretty good, huh? Tugs at the old heartstrings. You can see why everybody loves it. There's only one problem with it. It was a total flop. What? Yes. Why? Because it didn't move one carton of Coke. And that's its job. So, Sergio Zimon, the VP of marketing at Coke, yanked it off the air. Wow, people can't believe that. That's right. If you want entertainment, go buy a ticket somewhere. That's not what a commercial is for. But tomorrow, everybody will be seated around the TV voting for his favorite commercial. That's proof that it is a disaster. There you go. Everybody loved that commercial. Talked about it for years. Still talk about it. Didn't sell any Coke. Sergio Zimon, the VP of marketing at Coke, yanked it because that's its job. Let me dive into a sister subject, and that's naming stadiums. This year, the Super Bowl will be played in Las Vegas at Allegiant Stadium. Allegiant is paying $25 million per year for 30 years. That's only $750 million. For what? Naming stadiums is also a waste of money because people don't buy the products just because a company slaps its name on a stadium or an arena. I've talked about this before. I discussed it in my book, Brand is Destiny. Yet they do it anyway. It's all about ego. So, as you're sitting back with your friends this year watching Super Bowl 58, the 49ers versus the Chiefs, which I'm sure is going to be a fantastic game, keep this in mind when you're watching the commercials. All that money into these commercials, $7 million for 30 seconds, down the drain. Let's not forget the halftime show. Again, Apple is sponsoring it for $50 million. Usher's going to be the singer. He's going to get paid zero. Are you going to buy an iPhone because Usher is singing for 15 minutes and Apple's paying $50 million. I don't think you are. I'm not. I'm going to keep the one I have. Anyway, enjoy the game. And if you become a CEO of a major corporation, do not waste your company's money on Super Bowl commercials. That's it. This is Marc Rudov at MarcRudov.com. Until next time.